Hello to all my BPTV fans and YouTube fans. I'm back for my second Speedy Gourmet show, and I'm glad to bring you this show. Thanks for all the great feedback and comments and for watching my show. I appreciate it. I have a special fish for you tonight, and we're going to film it starting right now. And I got to start the stopwatch. Let me pull it up. All right. I'll get my fish. You'll see where it's from. We got a close up here, and it's a red snapper. They call it snapper or red snapper, but all snapper is red snapper. And I bought this a while ago, a couple months ago, and I'll show it to you. I ended up, it was a large piece and they had it on sale, and I cut it in half. So to try to show you that you can have flexibility, you don't have to cook that whole piece if you're actually making just a meal for yourself like I'm doing. And I'll wash it off here, give it a quick rinse. Okay, and it's a nice white, light tasting fish. And I'll just set it on the plastic here and I'll get rid of this. And I'm gonna cook an ancient grain. We'll keep the mystery of all my stuff. Here it is. Red quinoa. Very tasty ancient grain. And it's just delicious. And I'll show you how easy it is to prepare. Remember, I'm trying to inspire you to follow the Speedy Gourmet. I'll get a third of a cup here. Let's see what we got here. 1/3 of a cup. We'll go with that. And you only have to cook it for about 10 minutes. So it ties in with being speedy. I'll just show this for you. That's what it looks like. It's red quinoa. And I'll get a pot to put it in. Put about a cup of water in there. I'll dump it in, put it back. I always put things back so I don't have a lot of cleanup. That's my part to doing something simple and healthy. We'll put this back, seal it, put it back. Has a special place up front. Now we'll go to get our veggies. Got some zucchini, yellow squash, avocado for another day when it's ripe. Let me get my, I've talked about this last week, but if you're new to the show, I got this Cutco knife. My niece, when she was in college years ago, sold a bunch of these knives. They're great. They're very sharp. Look at the serrated edges. And I use it all the time. Let me rinse these off. Shake them dry. And here's how simple it is. I cut the ends off the zucchini. I'll throw those out. And here's how thick I make them. Probably less than half an inch, about a quarter, maybe 3/8. And I just keep cutting. Use my eye, watch my fingers. This knife is very sharp. And you can see you just cut them. And I'll get the nonstick tray, put some olive oil spray on it, and we'll go. Then I move them gracefully here. Yellow squash can be a little finicky at times. Cut the ends off. And I'll give it a go here. And I just do it, you can see I'm consistent on it. Sometimes the wider part is a little funky there. And I'll show you this. It starts to break apart. It's sort of like fluffy there, but it cooks up nice. And I'll just keep cutting it. And what I do is, I'm not going to eat all of this in one meal. I'm going to eat about half of it, 10 to 12 pieces of each. And I put that in my meal to stay with that healthy meal concept. And there you go, one more to do. Fingers are all good. Knife is down. Tray's coming up. And what we do is, I didn't tell anybody last time, but with my electric oven, I have to put it about 60, 70 degrees higher to cook my meal properly, because I had gas for years and grew up with it, and it seems to be more efficient. I've had other people complain. Here we go, my olive oil spray, and it helps to get absorbed with each vegetable and the fish. Because some people were noticing that I don't really marinate my fish or vegetables, and they go, how do you get any flavor? And I said, I usually use coconut, virgin coconut oil, or olive oil, organic, and I get the flavor there. So now we get the fish, put that piece right center it, grab the wet bag, try not to make a mess. Even though I'm a man, I try to stay clean, so that's part of it. I'll rinse the knife off for further use, set it on the side. Here's the big project now. I try to put rows of four, if you can see. There's a method to my madness. Keep it simple. You can do it. Look how easy it is. If you don't know how to cook, how can you not just count to four? In this case, three, because they're bigger. And you just put them all across. And make space. And we'll put one right in between there. There's flexibility. Then I got about 12 zucchinis. We'll make those for the other side. Put them on, and I'm gonna add some Brussels sprouts. Fresh Thyme, one of my favorite places. Get the Brussels sprouts. Like I was, you know what? Here's what I'm going to do. I just bought this the other day. Now, you want to know what this is? Butternut squash. Watch how simple. Cut this off. Put that to the side. I'll cut this. It's a little tougher for my knife. This will be another meal down the road. I split this in half. Watch your fingers. Be careful. And I cut it again in half. Then here's another trick. Nice thin pieces of this. With the skin, I had washed it before I put it on the counter, so it's clean. And I make a thin slice, as you can see. And this will also be saved. I'll refrigerate it for another meal. Because I eat healthy all the time. This isn't all I eat. I don't eat 100% healthy. I do like pizza once in a while. And Subway's 5 minutes from our house. So I do imbibe in a little bit of Subway. All right, we got to readjust a little. Watch how easy it is. Look. Mix them all up. Four more. We're going to be tight here. All right, we can squeeze it all in. I'll show you the masterpiece right here. This is going into the oven right now, so you can follow me. Head down there. Got to close the door. Put that in there, and about 12, 13 minutes, we'll come back. I now turn the water on for the quinoa. That'll kick in right now, and we'll get some action there. Brussels sprouts, saving you for another time. I do mix it up. a couple people I wanted to share this with you. They go, Al, do you ever eat peppers? Look what colors. Yes, and this was a full bag. So the Speedy Gourmet does mix it up with different veggies. And I do use onions, so I'll show you one of my Vidalia onions, but not today. I won't bring them all out for you guys, but these are great sweet onions, Vidalia onions. I love them. Mix them up, saute them, and they're just great. I use a lot of virgin coconut oil with it. I can show you that. Whoops. Pardon me, that's secret colloidal silver. Here's some organic virgin olive oil from Aldi's. That's my backup. Here's where I'm at on this. This is about halfway there. I get this from Trader Joe's. So you can stop at these places. I hit Aldi's, Trader Joe's, and Fresh Thyme. Have great success. So we'll check that. We got that out of the way. That's for some of my fans that wondered what else I eat. I can't show you everything. I have spinach in here, but that's another day. And we got a couple more things to cut. One is a clove of garlic. You can see that. I'll hold it so you can see the clove. And here's what I buy. Fresh Thyme has these. Look at how big these cloves of garlic are. And garlic is so healthy for you. Before antibiotics, guess what they used to do? Eat garlic all the time. Maybe we need to get back to it, in my opinion. All right, we'll cut this. I cut the tip off. Then I cut the other tip off. And I do a little slice. And it all peels off. The outer level peels off. And I'm going to grade this over top of the meal. So we'll save this for a coming attraction. And I have something else. I showed you last time, I got to get my ginger supply out. Here's a nice piece of ginger. We're going to grade that up. You can see that. And I keep it handy on the top of my refrigerator. I bought this years ago. Look how easy. It has two parts to it. Here's what I'll use today to grind it up. Grind it here, and it comes out on the other side. Very simple. Put this one in the side here. Put this one out to use. When we get there, we'll move the ginger. And I like to clean up like I explained. And look at how great this cutting board is. My daughter got it. Everything right in the garbage bag here. No mess. No fuss, no mess. We're good to go. Ginger is here waiting. I wanted to show you some of my green tea. I keep them in these jars and they're airtight. This is Young Hyson loose leaf green tea. This is China gunpowder loose leaf green tea again. Sometimes I even grab some of the leaves and put it in my meal. Not today, I'm not gonna get too exotic. Here's Lung Ching fourth grade, otherwise known as Dragonwell. And I wanted to show the leaves on here. We got the camera here. Look at how flat these leaves are. And they all come from the Camellia sensis bush, all green tea and black tea. And that's what the leaves look like, the bigger ones. And I might as well go back since I'm educating you a little bit. China gunpowder, they're like little beadlets. You can see how they are. Whoop. We'll have to get that later. And they open up in the tea ball or tea basket, and the flavor comes out within 2 minutes. And that's what I steep for. Now you know my secrets. And guess what I'm going to warm up next? You guessed it, green tea. That was my little tutorial. Here's a cup of water. 1 minute. 1 minute on the microwave, and that'll take it to almost boiling. Never boil your water for tea. Just get it for almost boiling. And you get a better flavor, and it'll turn out well. The quinoa is boiling and cooking very nice. So far, we're doing very well on this. Time check, we're about 15 minutes into it. So we'll be checking on our fish in a few minutes. Let's see what else we have here. We'll get the tea in a second. And this way it's not too hot. Five seconds to go. Here we are. Teacup here. To all my fans with the Penguin T-Ball. T-Ball has China gunpowder in it. I steep it in there, dunk it a couple times, and look at how the color, it releases the flavor. Look at the greenish color that you'll see. It's not a perfect green, but it does start turning. And we'll leave that on about 2 minutes. So we'll have that steady there. And I just wanted to share this. This is very simple. I have a few minutes. It's stress-free. There's no stress in making the meal. You can just watch this recording again and use the ingredients that I put out for you to use. And then just get your utensils ready to go, from my Cutco knife to my grater. We're all ready to go. And we just gotta wait. I'm gonna check on my fish, but I explained my daughter got me a great thermometer. And I never used one, and I'd had a guess on when it's ready. And you look for a temperature on fish of about 145. So we'll get this out, hopefully. There it is. Press the button, thermometer's out. And let me pull out this, we'll move this stuff over. Get my silicone gloves. Or mittens, nice silicone. Don't I look stylish with black and orange here for Bethel Park? There must have been a method to this madness. All right, let's see what we got going on here. Let you give a little preview. It's cooking up nicely. Let's see what our fish got. Have to press the button to turn it on. And we're at about 123, 124. So we probably need another 5 minutes here. 126 it hit. I'm going for more, 127. It's going up. Nope, back down. All right, we'll wash that off and take it back. Let me check these. I like my veggies crisp. I'll just turn these over real quick here. Just stab them, turn it over. Just flip them, because they're a little thicker than the zucchini and the yellow squash. And when the fish is ready, my veggies should be ready and edible at that time. So we'll check that. Zucchini, okay, nothing's burning. Yellow squash, nothing's burning. That's what you check. put the gloves back on, safety first. And we'll put it back in there. Watch the heat of it. And we got probably another 4 or 5 minutes to do that. So if you need a time check, we're right under 20 minutes. So we're moving right along. So just follow. Here we are with the tea. Look at the color now. And that's a perfect cup of loose leaf green tea, China gunpowder. Let me take a sip. Delicious. Sip by sip to your health. We'll put this on the side, get a little plate, because I got fans of the penguin, so I have to play it safe that he'll be out on the table when we post the last picture. So let's see what we got. A couple more minutes here. Let me put that squash away. See if I have a nice size bag for it. Just happen to have a nice size bag. This is how you can prepare for your next meal. Put it right in there. Real quick. Again, if you're doing this for the first time, you can see it isn't difficult. It's just repetition with what I've done. And as I'm known as the Speedy Gourmet, we'll save this for another day. And that's what I have for you. Another minute or two. I'm still warm from that oven. Started to get a little heated there. All right, we'll move this back here and we'll get ready. Let me rinse this again. One cut go clean. We'll wipe it off with a nice paper towel. Set it on the side if we have to clean up anything. And we're good to go. Let me check on the quinoa. I may just take a little taste. I just take a little pinch. You know what? They're ready. I can shut the stove off there. Top of the stove is off. We'll let it sit for a minute or two while we wait to check on. Let's see. Let me check our timer here. I think we can do it. Here we go. We're opened up. Gloves again. One and two. All right, we'll put it up here. We're a little further away from you. I'll close it. We may be done, but let me check that temperature. Was I right or what? I'll try to bring it closer to you. I think it just dropped. You might have to bring the camera here to, can you see that, Dave? Yeah. Okay, it just dropped. It was at 147. So we're ready. It's varying now because I got it out in the air. We'll get one of my utensils. See, there's a method to this. We'll get the fish. Put the fish right here. Move the garlic and ginger to the better position. Scrape a little bit of the fat that comes out of the fish. Then we'll grab some yellow squash. And you can see what happens. I'll just hold one. The inside makes it look like there's nothing there anymore. It just cooked away. And that happens with the seeds in there. Now we'll get the zucchini. And you can see some tell me I have a pretty good eye with this, so I do it a little color coordinated and mix it up a little bit. And I'll pile up that zucchini. I only got a, I'll save a few more for another day. All right, butternut squash. It's very tasty. We happen to have a nice spot there for it. I'm gonna get the quinoa out. And as you can see, I got a utensil that I can drain the water from. So it's draining. See how easy it is? Look at the red color of the quinoa. It's an ancient grain that's very good and healthy for you. And I spread it out along here. And I got to get another scoop. I put it there. One more scoop. And that's how easy it was. Now we're going to the key part. Make sure you watch this part here. Wait one second. I forgot my olive oil. Here we go. Little bit of olive oil on everything. Again. All right. Here we go for the finish. Shredded garlic over everything. You can see it. Watch your fingers. I've been doing it so long, have many cuts. I don't advise you to get cut. Then I scrape off the little bit that's hanging on there, spread it along here, and then we'll go with ginger, fresh ginger. Just start shredding it all around. There we go. You see it all ends up a little shredded for another day. There we go. Let me use a finger, put it off there. Rinse it all down. Leave it in the sink, clean as could be. All right, we're getting for the final touch. Rainbow peppercorn. I like a lot of it. It gives a nice little flavor to everything. There we go, folks. That is it. Speedy Gourmet finishes another meal. Very easy to make, very simplistic. Just take your time, be careful, and look what you have here. Another great meal. Stay tuned for our next show, and what fish will I bring out next? Enjoy your red snapper.